This is Jared Horak for today's RacingDigest.com, and in this Today's Racing Digest video, we're going to look back at the 2019 Kentucky Derby, and then we're going to preview the Preakness Stakes coming up next week at Pimlico Race Course. Now, the Kentucky Derby was not a pretty race this year. It was run on a sloppy, sealed main track. We saw maximum security up on the pace throughout, crossed the line first, but then he was disqualified for veering out, and he fouled at least two of his rivals, Long Range Toddy, was one of those rivals. War of Will was the other one. So he fouled those horses, and he caused a mess in the stretch. It looked like a lot of horses were able, or at least looked like they had a chance to make a move. None of them really did. It just looked like someone was going to move forward and pass him, but they couldn't. It wasn't, I think, that he was just so game. I just think that nobody wanted to go a mile and a quarter in those kind of conditions. It was a slow Kentucky Derby. The final half mile was in 51.43 seconds. I just think they just didn't, on that particular track, that wet track, no one really wanted to go that far. And Maximum Security was able to get out there early, get control, and he was able to hang on. But I don't think any of the top runners really ran big races whatsoever. So Country House was placed first. He's not coming back in the Preakness. Code of Honor was placed second. He's not coming back. Tacitus was third. He's not coming back. Maximum Security's not coming back for the Preakness either. But Improbable will come back for trainer Bob Baffert, and he's going to be your likely favorite. But he's lost all of his starts this year, so do you really want to take a short price on Improbable? They keep switching his riders. They took the blinkers off and on. Maybe he'll do better on a fast track because his last two races were on a wet track. War of Will could certainly move forward. He's one I did not like at all in the Kentucky Derby. I just knew that from that inner post, a bad final prep for him, that he was going to struggle in the Derby. He just wasn't going to be fit enough. But I figured he would run a decent race, be forwardly placed, and then he could move forward in the Preakness, just like Classic Empire did for Mark Cassie a couple years ago. And War of Will could be a contender in the Preakness. I think he's got a much better shot in that race. A win-win-win, a wide trip. He didn't run well on the wet track. Maybe on a fast track, he's at least an exotics contender in the Preakness. And then Bodexpress, still a maiden. I think he could be a pace factor in the Preakness, but that's about it. So those four horses could come back from the Derby and run in the Preakness. And then we have at least seven new shooters. Bourbon War, late runner, didn't get any pace help in the Florida Derby. That was a productive race. He's adding blinkers for the Preakness. Alwaysmining, the local hope. He's won six races in a row, five stakes races, and he has speed. Another Twist of Fate. He qualified for the Preakness when he won the El Camino Real Derby. Then he was second in the Sunland Derby, second in the Lexington Stakes in his last two. Laughing Fox, the son of Union Rags. He won the Oaklawn Invitational last time out, rallying from off the pace. He'll try to get involved late. Warrior's Choice for trainer Brad Cox. They're going to supplement him to the Preakness. He would be a pace factor if they decide to go. Owendale, he won the Lexington Stakes, rallying from off the pace. Then finally, Signalman for trainer Ken McPeak. Another one that likes to run from off the pace. A minor award in the Preakness would not be impossible. So right now, those are the 11 horses that could run in the Preakness Stakes. And we'll know more next week when they make final decisions on who exactly is going to run in the Preakness. But at least, I say 9 or 10 of those horses are pretty solid to run in the second jewel of the Triple Crown. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make some comments in the comment section. Who do you like in these probables for the Preakness Stakes in 2019? The Today's Racing Digest complete digest for Preakness Day from Pimlico will be available next week at todaysracingdigest.com, along with my full card from Pimlico on Preakness Day. You can find both of those products at todaysracingdigest.com. That will wrap up this week's video. We'll be back next week with another stakes race from around the country.